is what you feel. And when the Spirit of God touches you, you will holler. Will shout. You have to run and tell somebody, because you just can't keep it to yourself.
Tell them what you want. Call them up. Call them up. Tell them what you want. Call them up and tell them what you want.
That which is coming to us tonight, as far as I'm concerned, is a gift of God.
And we give our gifts, as we give our gifts. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever. Amen.
Let's say it one more time. Just as I am, help me lead it, Lord. We meet you, Lord.
Yes.
Just as we are, dear God, we need you. Someone among us needs you, dear Jesus. Someone is hurting, someone is hurting one of us. Someone is really hurting one of our children. Just say, just as I am.
The demonstration of a group using their talent to portray an idea and to expose to all of us what can be done when one man lets God use him. Forget it. We can express our appreciation to all of you who are gathered tonight. For we have a story to tell to the nations. The story of God's goodness and God's love. This is that moment for which we have waited. And now all things are ready. I'm glad tonight to be a part of this experience. On behalf of the Second Baptist Church, I present to you the narrator.
First of all, we want to say praise the Lord. We thank God for being here tonight. We didn't come tonight to put on a program. But we love the Lord tonight, and we just came to render service to him. And we came to display in basic and simple terms the message of man striving to do the will of God. Truly, we're glad tonight that Jesus paid the price for your sins and for mine. We're glad that he died on Calvary. And a crowd, it seemed, stood around the dogwood tree. And I whispered softly to one standing by, "Hey, what's happening? And this fellow, who is he?" And you know, his reply rang very clear to me. He said, "Hey, that's Jesus Christ, some man from Galilee." But then I recall
belong to me. I said, why are they riveting his precious feet? Because he says that he's the Son of God. And is that why his brow was marred with blood? You know, my heart began to swell as I pushed by a crowd with blood and envy in its eyes. And then I began to wonder why those that he so marvelously blessed had failed to testify. I believe that Lazarus would have told them how he made death behave. For after he was dead 4 days, Christ got him out of the grave. And I'm sure that just one testimony would have hushed that sickening cry of those all round about him, shouting, crucify him! Crucify! All the sight was most unbearable.
Tonight. And we're reminded tonight of the words that the Lord spoke to the Apostle Peter one night when he had bid him come on out on the water. And Peter stepped out and fear overtook him. And then he said, oh, Peter, I'm your Lord and Master. I'm Lord of land and I'm Lord of sea. And Peter, if you put your faith in me and keep your eyes on me, then you can walk out on the water. And you don't have to be afraid.
Thank you. this is all about.
Just trust me.
Huh? No, no.
Trust me.
No, no, I trust me.
No, no.
Huh?
You need me.
No, no.
No.
What?
I'll make you my right hand man.
You sure
I will.
Oh, you kidding?
Carry my staff. Walk by my side.
Really?
Sure.
There you are.
Give me anything you want. Just name it. Come on.
Well, you're all right if you're going to make me your right-hand man and walk by your side
That's
and
right.
carry yourself,
That's
man,
right.
you're all right with me. Yeah, he's all right with me.
I don't know about you, but sometimes my load gets mighty heavy. And there was a time when I didn't have anywhere to go. But you see, I called on Jesus in my distress. And I want you to know this. He answered me quickly, and he's never failed me yet. And I'm going to tell the whole world, don't care where I go, that I sure enough found a Savior. And he's sweet. He's sweet, I know.
That's it.
Take it.
Take it?
It's yours.
You mean? You gonna give me this diamond
it's
ring?
Yours.
As large as it is, man, look.
Anything for you.
I've always wanted a diamond ring this large. Look at that. Wow, and you mean this, man?
It's yours to keep.
Well, look here. You might be sweet, but this diamond ring is sweet. Look at here. My goodness.
You know, we have to give Satan credit for one thing. He's about his business. Can the church say amen? It's about time for us to get about ours. You see, sometimes I get a little weary, and my load gets a little heavy. And all Satan will come by and say, hang it up, queen. You can't make it. But I recall the words of the master. He said, if you're burdened, and if you're heavy laden, just come on to me, and I'll give you rest. He said, my yoke is easy, and my burden is light. And I thank God, because I know today that Satan is alive. Because these old heavy burdens cannot last.
I will make it fly. Thank you.
burden.
Will you just wait right here?
Hey, well, look here. You gonna give me a burden?
A burden.
Make it, make sure it's a heavy one, buddy.
All right.
Because, hey, look,
right
I'm
here.
A strong man. Yes, sir. I can carry any kind of burden.
Yes.
What?
Come on, buddy. You can't carry
me. Oh, yeah, yeah. Well, I'm going to show him. I'm going to show him that I can carry any kind of burden. Hey.
Now,
man, you sure gave me a heavy burden, all right.
Didn't I tell you it was too heavy for you?
Yeah, but I can carry it.
You'll never make it.
Yeah, I'll make it.
Come on. No. Put it down. Come on.
No.
Come on, let me help you.
No, it's all right. I'll make it.
I'm going to light this burden for you. I'm going to light it for you right
no,
now.
No, no, no. It's all right. I'll get it. I'll
yes,
get it.
I'm going to light it for you.
You see what he did?
Man.
No.
What?
He never done a thing.
You mean he didn't write in his verse? Oh, no, man. No. You got to be pulling.
It was me.
You got to be pulling my leg. You got to be pulling my leg.
No.
Huh?
I'm the one that lightened that burden.
You lightened this
burden? Sure I did. Hey, didn't I tell you I could do anything?
Yeah, you told me that.
That's right. Well, just believe me.
But what did he do?
Nothing. Not a thing. Your eyes were just deceiving.
You mean,
he never done a thing. You mean, trust me.
You mean you
I like it.
And he didn't?
Not a thing. Not one single solitary thing. Just believe me.
Boy, if you lighten this burden, as heavy as it was, you're all right with me. Yes, sir. Look at how I like that burden. Look at that.
You know, some of the things that you see going on down the aisle seem a little comical. But all we're doing is trying to show you in basic, simple terms what the devil is doing to you and I every single day. You know, many times in my life, I have wanted an easy way. Many times I've been deceived by Satan. Many times I've even tried to make God prove himself. But when the way got hard, I said, Lord, if you be God, then move the mountain. But you know, the mountain didn't move. Many times I got down on my knees and cried and said, Lord, I'm tired and I'm weary. Move the mountain. But the mountain didn't move. And I pleaded with God, but I kept on trying. And you know, I opened my eyes one day and I saw that I had gone up just a little bit higher. And today I got a new prayer. Today I can say, Lord, I don't want you to move the mountain. But I believe that you've got all power, so just give me the strength to climb. And Lord, when Satan put stumbling blocks all in my way, don't move the stumbling block, but take my hand and hold me fast and lead me. Lead me, Lord, around.
Oh,
got Fowler up this mountain, so that's what
I'm... You don't need to climb that high.
Oh, yeah, I can climb it.
Come on, just stay down.
If she can climb it and she's a woman, I know I can climb it. Yes, sir, and I'm a man.
You've been out in the world with me, too.
Huh?
You don't need to climb that mountain.
No, I won't climb this mountain.
You just wait right here.
I won't climb this mountain just to prove to you that I can climb it.
That's an easy way for you.
No, what?
You don't... It's an easy way.
Well, you mean you got an easier way than climbing this rough mountain?
That's right. Just wait.
What's your easy way?
Just wait.
Okay. You're going to make it easy. Anything easy, I'm for that. Yes, sir. Hey, look at that. A race car. Look here. I don't have to climb up that old rugged, rough mountain.
No.
I can drive around the mountain. Hey, you're all right. You know it.
I can get into this.
You know, I'm reminded of one day my husband and I went to Dairy Queen. And I saw a little bitty bird. And I said, oh, baby, there's a baby bird. And he said, honey, where you come from? That's a full-grown sparrow. And I looked at it. And all I could say is, well, you know what? If his eyes on that sparrow, then I know he's watching me.
His eyes might be on the sparrow, but my eyes are on you. Hey, look at him. Ooh.
Satan sure knows what to get us with.